Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and you're all very welcome here this evening to St. Lawrence's Church in Fintona to our fifth annual carol service. I'd like to begin with our housekeeping and ask if you have a mobile phone with you, can you please turn it to silent now or turn it off? The other thing I would like to point out are our safety exits, and the two exits at the rear, as you know, and we also have the exits here at either door into the oratory or into the and through the sacristy. Today is a special day in the church. Today is Gaudete Sunday, Rejoicing Sunday. And what a way to rejoice at the coming of the Saviour by singing and praising his name in carols. Family is always very important around Christmas. And today we celebrate the family, the first Christian family, the Holy Family. But we remember also those of our own families, those who maybe have passed since this time last year, those who are unable to be with us this evening, but are with us in heart, those who we'd like to remember in a special way at this time as we begin by singing Adeste Fideles.
Free on fountains, any First reading. The prophets foretell the birth of a Saviour. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. They lived in a land of shadows, but now the light is shining on them. A child is born. A son is given to us, and he will be our ruler. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. His royal power will continue to grow. His kingdom will always be at peace.
Thank you. The angel visits Mary. In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to a town in Galilee named Nazareth. He had a message for a young woman named Mary. The angel came to her and said, "Peace be with you," and greatly blessed her. Mary was deeply troubled by the angel's message and wondered what his words meant. The angel said to her, "Don't be afraid, Mary. God has been gracious to you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High God. The Lord God will make him a king of the descendants of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end."
Third reading, the decree is issued. At that time, the Emperor Augustus ordered a census to be taken throughout the Roman Empire. When the first census took place, Quirinius was the governor of Syria. Everyone then went to register himself, each to his own town.
Mary and Joseph travelled to Bethlehem. Joseph went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to the town of Bethlehem in Judea, the birthplace of King David. Joseph went there because he was a descendant of David. He went to register with Mary, who was promised in marriage to him.
Thank you. Fifth reading, Mary gives birth to her son. While they were in Bethlehem, the time came for Mary to have her baby. She gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in cloths and laid him in the manger, because there was no room for them to stay in the inn.
shepherds hear the news. There were some shepherds spending the night in the fields, taking care of their flocks. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone over them. "Don't be afraid. I am here with good news for you, which will bring great joy to all people. This very day in David's town, your Savior was born, Christ the Lord. You will find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger."
Seventh reading, the shepherds go to Bethlehem. When the angels went away from them back to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and saw the baby lying in a manger. When the shepherds saw him, they told them what the angel had said about the child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said. Mary remembered all these things and thought deeply about them. The shepherds went back singing praises to God for all they had heard and seen. It was just as the angel told them.
sweet moon. Earth stood hard as iron, water like a stone.
Snow and falling, snow on snow, snow on snow. In the bleak midwinter,
I'm
The wise men followed the star. Jesus was born in the town of Bethlehem in Judea during the time when Herod was king. Soon afterwards, some men who studied the stars came from the east to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the baby born to be king of the Jews? We saw his star when it came up in the east, and we have come to worship him."
We
I'm sure you'll all agree that that was something else. I think everybody here, first of all, deserves a round of applause. As you all know, something like this doesn't happen just at the drop of a hat. It takes an awful lot of work to get this standard of singing and this standard of performance together. And this practice, or this choir, or these two choirs, have been practicing together since the beginning of October, when we met and we decided the theme that we would use for tonight's carol service. I'd like to thank all of those who are involved in making sure that this came off as well as it did. I'd like to thank our greeters, Seamus and Pat, who greeted you at the door, along with Anne and Marie. I'd like to thank our readers, Vincent, Caitlin, Julie, Jenny, Conal, Joe, Brona and Aoife. I'd like to thank our sound engineer, Eamon, Aisling, who's directing us with the laptop here. I'd like to thank our lighting engineer, Ronan. I'd like to thank Owen McWilliams and Kevin Wilson and Marty Nixon and Tommy McWilliams, who built the staging here for tonight. I'd like to thank most of all the choirs who have put in hours of dedication, hours of practice to be able to be here tonight to perform in this carol service for us, which, as I said at the beginning, is dedicated to the Holy Family on this most holy days, Gaudete Sunday, the day that we rejoice, and today we surely have rejoiced. I'd like to thank, in a special way, Geraldine, who has put such an effort into making sure that everything was just tip-top here this evening. And again, I'd like to thank Justin, who's here accompanying on guitar. And most of all, I'd like to thank you for taking the time out to come out and to listen and to encourage these children and adults by your presence that they're not actually wasting their time here practicing and making sure that they could entertain. Thank you all very much. Good night.
Thank you.
walking in a winter wonderland.
Walking in a winter wonderland. There is no land. There is no land.
wish you a merry